Okay, so last time I managed to get it, loaders to read YAML, return everything. Not exactly the greatest at this point. Especially with the fragment descriptors and all this stuff. Not great. So, I'm going to do. What am I going to do this time? I'm going to see if I can try to abstract so I don't actually have to bring in YAML reader itself. Or let's say the other one, which would be like. I don't know. IMAX will be the generic one at the bottom. They'll have the interface. YAML, then we'll have binary, then. Shader, fragment descriptor, and of course, which would be these would be. Actually, these should probably be sitting in here. Start with shader. Shader is the easiest one. Or rather, no, fragment descriptor. It's got a bit of everything. Let's go down the loader. So much like the YAML one, I think it'll be. Right, rather it'll be like export. Fragment descriptor declaration. And we have two imports. Same thing, basically, but for importing. When we're exporting, it'll just be. We're importing. Writing. Okay, no, for importation. What? I'd need the pool, wouldn't I? Or would I? Could I just do a string and... Okay, we'll just leave that kind of there for the moment. Exporting. Yes, this is doable. Export the declaration of this. When we're exporting, we can also just... Yeah, exporting is easy. We can just use these. It's the importation that's probably difficult. Okay, let's just say we're just importing the definition. So it's just a standard string, which is the fragment shader. Basically these guys. Otherwise, when we're importing the declaration, it's the name. Yeah, he's bringing in Vulcan stuff for the moment. Which means these don't have to be public anymore. They could just be private, since this would I'd also need to export these. No, these can be in a separate library as long as they both import this guy. And the base. Yeah. This Fores IMEX export. Okay, we don't need these guys. No, we do need the include directories. Then I also need some kind of mechanism to something down here. Shader. Important shader definition, which will be a bunch of other things. These things. I don't even know if importing the declaration is really something that needs to be public. I don't think it would be. Well, whatever. So then what I'm going to do is this is going to take off of that. Faux resource. That. What's going to happen is we're going to have, instead of this, this would all speed, this would become an IMX. So first of all, yes. Quite. I need to import it. Of course. No sources. Is this not an interface? This is not an interface. Fine so far, fine so far. Let's just do that for the moment. Okay, so moving down to Fragment Descriptor, we have these three functions we want to create, or four. Close all. This, and this. Okay, move it off to the side, grab the copyright. which is this. So we'll just do exporting of both. Do I want to do export? Export's fast. No. I don't really need the declaration stuff, do I? Do I? I don't think I do. I really can't think of a... Because it'd be the internal stuff. So just be these, actually. Get rid of the declaration ones. These are the ones I care about. Yes, I need that as well. So what I do when I'm importing the fragment descriptor is I am going to call the YAML stuff that surrounds it first. Import fragment descriptor definition, which requires what? Which requires the name. I need that. Change tracks. Okay, we're here. We have fragment descriptor name. We got this. Clear those guys out. Dot YAML. We include faux log for the moment. Really? Can't find that? Faux resource. IMX. Fragment descriptor. There we go. That's why. Back to loader. Then we do this. We return. We try that. Return true, but we gotta try. This. We catch. What do we have in here? It'd be like a faux YAML exception. Then we'd have to faux log general error failed to fragment descriptor definition this, and then we'd have whatever e dot what is. And then return false, because it obviously didn't load from here. Then what I think I'll do is in the fragment loader, I can abstract this stuff down to, hold on, let me change this to copy this for a moment. Should mean that exists now. Looks like it. Okay. Then I can call this instead, considering we have the back end now filled with by YAML. Okay, so we've got fragment descriptor name, which would be this. And then these other guys, fragment shader and all this stuff. Reading is true. Okay. So that means I can just keep the exception code all inside the sublibrary now. I don't need the YAML stuff here. I have error codes, right? Import failed. I need something down here for import failed. Loading failed. tucked all these in a subscope so I can actually do the jump. No more YAML. Okay. So that's... Now I want to probably... now I need to change this into a plugin because I'll have more than one. I have the YAML, I have the binary. Importers and exporters. Unless I want to keep pulling... names out every time. Do I? I don't think I do. Whatever. I'll finish abstracting the rest of these and I'll get on to the next stage of nonsense. Okay, one thing is true though, I don't need this to be public anymore. I will for the moment, actually. Still gotta convert the others over. So when I was saving these, I had this code in the application. Somewhere. This is the initialize sector. Here we go, deinitialization. I was just reading it straight into a file of that. Okay. Just this. Well, that's died. That's great. Otherwise, what is this? This would be like a try catch, right? Something like that, yeah. Can I just... export it now? Can I just try that? Of the... and the frag... descriptor. I want to make sure these are all saved, yeah. Go through, run it, save it, see if it changes. Doesn't look like it. It does come through, right? I'm not crazy. Okay, what if I actually say like that too, but YAML, just to be sure. Nice, it is actually working as I expect. Leaves the material at the top level. Fragment descriptor, YAML shader. Okay. So then we're gonna do material and shader. Don't care about that. Don't care about that one right now. Okay, and it's just, instead of this, it's just shader. No, it's material. I don't actually know what I'm doing from material yet. Leave it blank. Back to material public. Cancel that. Do this, but for shader. Okay, so what do we need from a shader? These guys. I do need the shader name. Just thinking about something. It's not going to look pretty. Shader name. E dot what? Read shader definition. It's going to be the shader loader stuff. Do I not write the shader definition yet? Do I not have this? Read, write shader definition. This. Oh, I need the graphics session. Okay. Close everything to the right. Recompile. Make sure shader public is now on there. It doesn't fail. Move back to the shader loader. Change that up to be using. That. Instead of this, we're going to be read, then we do the maybe I want to have this return the error code instead, actually. That would make a bit more sense. Yeah, it kind of would. I'll do that in a second. First of all, I want to make sure that this is actually going to work. Ah, good, it didn't. Import shader definition. Okay. Is this because I don't have the export? Yeah. Okay. So we get rid of this. Get rid of the YAML. Get rid of the YAML. Do I need this? I don't think I need this. Do I need this either? No, I do. I did need that for this. Okay, one more. Material definition stuff. So what's in it for for the material? Oh, these are just writing. I don't have any reads in here yet. Okay, simple enough. The only thing it really uses right now is a fragment descriptor, isn't it? That's it. It's just a fragment descriptor. Oh wow, material's still using this. All right. I have write. I do have writing though. So we'll get the export definition stuff out of the way at least. Wait, did I not do this on Fragment Descriptor? Oh, no, hold on. Wait, where am I looking at? That's there, yes. I put it on the wrong one. Okay, see if we can export this in the application. So, no. Application export material definition of and the material to basically be the same as this. It's just fragment descriptor. Anything going? Oh, I don't even have it compiled in, do I? Yeah, that's fine for the moment. So I can get rid of this. No more of this. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Okay, that should mean I can probably move these guys. I can do two things. One, I can move these into private side. One thing is, it's just these are now private, like this. Did I do? No. No, come on. There we go. Did I do something here? No, I did not. Public. This one, though, yes. Hold on, I must be, yeah, okay, hold on. That makes sense. Oh, no. Screw that. Screw that one up. What about these guys? CPP? This. That's fine. Fragment descriptor? Yeah. I'll delete that later. This is bad. Oh yeah. I need to remove these. I don't need to export these symbols anymore. We also don't need this anymore. Should also mean there's probably somewhere else we're having a bit of a for resource was using it. Okay. Clear that out. That takes a little while. I need to put some things in. So I don't lose, I need to commit something. Let's clear those guys out. We'll do error code. We had these, so we need to move them around. Right now, this is still loading from that. Okay. Okay, it's just this stuff. What about this? For the moment, yes. Actually, if I didn't have this, it just wouldn't link up, right? For the moment. Because I'm not actually importing it as a plugin yet. Yeah. It imports and exports via. It imports and exports via YAML files. Okay, what's it? Just over an hour. Do I want to do something else right now? I need to. Okay, it's abstracted, but I still need to properly expand it to a plugin and figure out the priority mechanism for it. All right, I'll leave it there, I guess, for the moment. Cheers.